In today's class, we will discuss velocity diagram of a given steam engine. So this is the textbook question I have written. So first I will read the question. In a theoretical steam engine, crank length is 0.5 meters and crank speed is 180 rpm. It is clockwise. Okay. And the connecting rod length is 2 meters. When crank has turned 45 degrees from inner dead center position, at this position, find first one velocity of the piston. We need to find the velocity, linear velocity of the piston. Next one is we have to find angular velocity of connecting rod. Here we are using the symbol omega or small w. Okay, we have to find this connecting rod angular speed. And third one is we need to find velocity of a point capital E on the connecting rod. This point is on the connecting rod. We have to find this velocity. So this point is, E point is 1.5 meter from the Gordian pin. We have to mark this E point. We have to find the velocity. Here in this problem, three questions are given. We need to find the velocities. So for finding these velocities, we have to do the velocity diagram. In this question, steam engine is not given. Just for explaining this, I took this diagram, steam engine diagram. It is converting reciprocating motion into rotary motion. So here I have marked all the given dimensions. So in the exam, whenever steam engine is coming, instead of doing the entire diagram, you do this part as triangle here. Okay, so not necessary to do this diagram. So remember it. Just for explaining this, we did this diagram. OB is the crank I am taking. Okay, always remember crank length is less compared to the other links. So how much crank length it is given? It is 0.5 meters. So I am marking this diagram roughly. I am doing here, not necessary to do entire diagram, just do one crank here, OB crank. How much length it is? 0.5 meters it is given here. What is the speed of this crank is 180 rpm, it is given clockwise. So I did one mark here, n is equal to 180 rpm. I am marking alphabets OB, okay, crank. And now next line is, when crank has turned 45 degrees from the inner dead center position, okay, this crank is turning clockwise. Okay, so whenever this crank path is circular path, okay, like this, it is moving in the circular form. This point we are calling ODC, outer dead center position. Whenever crank is coming here, this position is called outer dead center position, and here when the crank is coming here, it is called inner dead center position. Okay, he has given it is making 45 degrees from the inner dead center. This is the inner dead center, it is making 45. This is 45 crank is making. So OP position has given. And then next is, what is the connecting rod length? Connecting rod length is 2 meters. So here I am taking B, here it is a crank end. BP is the connecting rod. Okay, it is 2 meters. Okay, here I am taking the connecting rod PB. Okay, and as you know, P is the Gordian pin on the slider. Okay, slider is moving horizontally, we know about it. So that's why this P and O are passing through the same axis. This is the axis line. Okay, just do this rough diagram by taking these dimensions. Okay, and here I did the diagram. In this diagram, I am taking O as one point. I took 45 degrees line because this crank is making 45. And the 45 degrees line, this mark this length, crank length, it is 0.5 meters. Here 0.5. So from B to P, how much it is? It is 2 meters. Okay, from B to P, it is 2 meters. Okay, just do roughly without scale or drafter this diagram. And now next we have to mark the E point. Where is the E point? E is on the connecting rod, which is 1.5 meter from the Gordian pin. Okay, here I did. This is the Gordian pin. From the Gordian pin, I have marked E point on the connecting rod. How much distance? 1.5 meters. So the same E point I have marked here. 1.5. PE is 1.5. So this diagram according to the given dimension roughly. Okay. So just remember, whenever steam engine is given, you have to do this type of diagram instead of doing this one. Just for explaining the function of steam engine, I did this diagram. The function of steam engine is, it is converting reciprocation motion into rotary motion of the crank. Okay, for explaining this, I did this diagram. No need to do this in the exams. Just according to the given data, whenever steam engine is coming, you do this diagram only roughly. First,
After that, by taking the correct dimensions by using scale, you have to do the space diagram. Okay, let us take the space diagram.
Here I am taking the space diagram. In this diagram, we can't take half meter, 2 meters on this board. Okay, correct. So we will take only in centimeters by using the scale. Okay, what I am doing is I am considering this half meter, whatever smallest length, it is equal to some 3 centimeters. We can assume any value here. It is called scale. Okay, so in space diagram, just we are taking this bigger lens into, we are reducing all the lengths. Okay, we will get the small diagram here. So convert all dimensions. This one we have converted. Next 2 meters we have to find. The scale we are taking is 0.5 meters means it is 3 centimeters. For 2 meters length, how many centimeters we have to consider. Okay, for small length it is also small, for bigger one it is bigger one. So more by less into 3 centimeters. So here we can take which length it is, connecting rod, BP length. Okay, what is more value in these two? 2 by 0.5 into 3. Okay, how much it is? Half, 4 into 3, 12. So here we will get this value, 12 centimeters. Okay, BP length is 2 meters. Instead of 2 meters, we can take 12 centimeters. Okay, this crank we have changed and this connecting rod we have changed. And the next length is 1.5 meters. That is PE. Okay, PE length. How much it is? 1.5 meters. For 1.5 meters, how many centimeters we have to take? For 0.5 meters, it is 3. For less, it is also less. For more, it is also more. So more by less, here I will write more by less into 3. Okay. This value is, what is more value? 1.5 by this value is, less value is 0.5 into 3. How much we are getting? So it is 9 centimeters. Okay. This PE length is 9 centimeters. Now by using this scale, we have converted all these big lengths into small lengths. Crank length 3 centimeters and connecting rod length is 12 centimeters and PE length is 9 centimeters. Do this diagram. Already I did this diagram according to the dimensions. Okay, what I am doing is, so already I did the space diagram. I did this diagram by fixing the drafter. So just I will tell the procedure how to do this triangular shape here. So use a drafter for getting the correct values, because we are, after this we are constructing the velocity diagram. For it we need drafter compulsory. Okay, just I will explain how to construct this triangular shape. I have marked O here. I did one horizontal line. Okay, that is the axis line. Okay, like this. Now on it I took 45 degrees by using the protractor. Okay, 45 degrees line here I get. Okay, so here I will get, so I did one line by using the scale. Okay, like this, 45 degrees line. And how much OB length? It is 3 centimeters. So I took 3 on it. Okay, so I will get OB length. Okay, next is, from B point, what is the PB length? PB length we have calculated 12 centimeters by using compass. Okay, by using compass I took 12 centimeters on this scale. So from B I did one arc. Okay, it is 12 centimeters on this horizontal line. Okay, so it is a P point. Okay, this is the arc. Now here, next is, after getting connecting rod, take PE length. That is, how much it is? 9 centimeters. So by using scale, from P I took 9 centimeters on this line, we will get E point. Okay, so this is a given space diagram. After the space diagram, we will construct the velocity diagram. In velocity diagram, we are marking all linear velocities. Linear velocity units are meter per second. Okay, we are using symbol capital V. Okay, but here we are getting the crank velocity. It is given. It is 180 rpm. We have to convert this into linear velocity first. Do this and convert into linear velocity. Crank is making 180 rpm. And here angular velocity, I am taking small w or omega, 2 pi n ob by 60. 2 pi n ob means it is 180 here divided by 60. So we are getting 6 pi. By using calci, we are getting 18.85, okay, radians per second. Our main aim is we are finding the linear velocity. So v is equal to, so linear velocity of crank, v ob is equal to omega OB into given length, original length of the link, OB link, or original length of the crank. What is omega OB means? Just now we did 18.85 into what is OB length, what is the crank length, original length. It is 0.5 meters. So I am taking 0.5 meters here. So do we can see. The value is 9.424 meters per second. Okay. Just now we did the linear velocity of OB. We did here how much it is 9.424 meter per second. Here for constructing this velocity diagram again we have to take scale because we are using the scale for doing it. So units are here meter per second. We are taking in centimeters. So just I am taking scale here, 9.424 meter per second is equal to, I am taking some 4 centimeters. Okay, this scale I am considering here, and in this space diagram, so O is a fixed point, so at which crank is rotating. Okay, so zero velocity it has, so mark fixed point at here, it is zero. Okay, and then slider velocity is horizontal always. Okay, we don't know, we have to find that velocity, slider velocity. Just do one horizontal line here by using the drafter, because it may be in this direction or in this direction. Okay, so this slider velocity is horizontal. Okay, and then next one is OB velocity. OB velocity is perpendicular to this link position. Always remember, velocities are perpendicular to the position of the link. Why means, if you are taking one wheel, okay, so here, if you are taking the velocity here, it is in this direction, perpendicular to the link. If you are taking the velocity here, this velocity direction is perpendicular to this link. Like that, whatever velocities we are taking, those are perpendicular to the position of the link. Okay, here OB velocity is perpendicular to this link. How much OB velocity? It is 9.424 meter per second, but here we are taking scale, it is equal to 4 centimeters. So here I will keep one of the scale here. Okay, one of the scale is coinciding with the crank, the another scale will show the velocity. How much velocity it is? 4 centimeters. So from O, because from O we are taking, it is 4 centimeters. Okay. Now join O and this value. So this end point is small d. Always remember, in velocity diagrams we have to mark small letters instead of capital letters. Okay, this is OB velocity. Okay, and then here I am marking V OB or VO, we can mark. Okay, and then next velocity is this PB velocity. We don't know this value, we have to find it. Okay, so we just fix the drafter scale here, it should coincide one of the scale, this link, and velocity we can do here because it is, velocity is perpendicular to this link. We know B point here. Okay, from B to this line, horizontal line, just do one line here. Okay, so this is this value, this point is P. Okay, the direction is like this. Okay, this value is linear velocity of VBP. Here write down capital letters. Okay, this is the slider velocity, VOP. Okay, this length will give this value, this length will give this value. Now measure this length. Here we are getting the values 3.45. okay, 3.4 and 5, 3.5 middle, so 3.45 centimeters. This value is, BP value is, this is 2.9. okay, 2.9. so this is 2.9 centimeters. So we are getting velocities in centimeters, we need velocities in meter per second. Already we took one scale here, that is 4 centimeter is equal to 9.242 meter per second. Now for finding velocity of slider, VP or VOP, VP we will take because slider velocity. Okay, VP we have to find. How much this value? 3.45. for 4 centimeters this value is 9.424, for 3.45 centimeter how much this value? For more value it is also more, for less it is less. Less by more into 9.424, Okay. So here, what is the less value? 3.45 divided by more value is 4 into 9.424. So by using calcium, we are getting this value is, this value we are getting 8.149 is 8.15 meter per second. Okay. So velocity of slider is Vp, how much it is? It is 8.15 meter per second. So here we need to write, it is question, slider velocity is 8.15 meter per second. Okay. And then next is omega Pb. First we need to find Vpb. So Vpb means this value, it is 2.9 centimeters. Again we have to find out velocity by using the scale. Here I will write, so Vb for Vp length, it is 2.9 centimeter. Okay, so for 4 centimeter this value is 9.424 meter per second. For 2.9 centimeters, how much this value? So for more value, it is also more. For less, it is also less. Less by more into this value, 2.4. How much this value? Less means in it 2.9 by more value means 4 into 9.424. This value by using the currency, how much we are getting? Some 6.8. okay, 6.8 meter per second. Okay, so this is the linear velocity of Vbb. Meter per second. We need to find the angular velocity in question. Okay, so here we have one formula. Here I will do linear velocity is equal to angular velocity into length of the original length of this link. Okay, as we know Vpb, just now we have calculated 6.8 is equal to, we need to find this value omega Pb into, what is the Pb length, original length? Pb length is, this is the Pb length connecting rod, it is 2 meters. So I am taking here 2. So by using the calcium, omega Pb is equal to 6.8 by 2 means 3.4 radians per second. Okay. So here whatever value is coming, it is the required value. Here I will write 3.4 radians per second. Okay, these two are the required answers. And next is E point we are taking. We need to find linear velocity of E. Where we have marked the E point is 1.5 meters from the P, Gordian P. Here for marking E point in the velocity diagram, we have to mark E on the Pb line. Which is a Pb line? This is a Pb line. Okay, so we have to mark at one of the place. So how to, where the E point? We don't know about it. Here for finding it, we have to compare these two triangles. One triangle is POP, one triangle here I have written. Another triangle is, this is in small letter. Always remember velocity diagram is in small letter. So here POB, okay, small letters. POB. Okay. So I am comparing these two triangles. We can compare the ratios also. PE by PB is equal to, we don't know E point. Let us assume at one of the point. So small PE by PB. Why we are taking PB means we know the length. By measuring it already we did in the last class. It is 2.9 centimeters. Okay. By using it, we know PE value here. We know PB value here. We know small Pb value, we can find this value. Okay, so by using it, we can find the position of E. Substitute these values. What is Pe here? Just now we took 9 cm. Okay, this is 9. 9 by, what is Pb value? 12. Okay. Is equal to Pe, we don't know, small Pe. What is Pb value? Yesterday we did 2.9 cm. Now by using calcium, find this value. Here I do PE is equal to 9 by 12 into 2.9. So how much we are getting? Take the calcium do. By using calcium we got this 2.175 centimeters. So on this PB line, from P point mark this distance. So use the drafter scale, 2.175. So 2.1, mark 2.1. Okay, this is the E point. Okay. Now how to find the velocity? Here join O and E. Okay, O and E. This length will give the velocity of E point. Now what I am doing is I am joining O point to E. OE. This length is giving the velocity of E point. Okay, this is, so it is between 3.4 and 3.5. So 3.45 OE length is. So here I will write 3.45 centimeters. Okay, so this value will give the velocity of E point. Okay, so VE we can find by using this value. And here we got this length in centimeters. Here in velocity diagram yesterday we did, we took one scale, in it we took 4 centimeter is equal to 9.424 meter per second. So here we got this length 3.45 centimeter is equal to, because velocity is in meter per second, we need to find how much velocity. Okay, for more value it is also more, for less it is also less. Less by more into this value 424. Okay, so what is less in it? 3.4 by 4 into 9.424. So how much it is? By using the calci we can get 8.128, okay, or 8.1 meter per second. Okay, so velocity of E point is, here we can write 8.1 meter per second. Okay, this is the linear velocity of E. So this one is the question here, velocity of point E. So it is 8.1 meter per second. Okay, so in this way we can find the velocity of any point of the connecting rod. If some other point is asking, some G point is some 1 meter from the Gaussian pin, so we have to mark that point here first from P point. Okay, and we have to mark that point in the space diagram. Okay, after that in the velocity diagram we have to mark that point. So for getting that position of the point, we have to compare these two triangles like this. Okay, and we have to take the ratio, some PE by PB is equal to, here also PE by PB, like this. If G point we are taking, we can take PG by PB is equal to PG by PB. Okay, so we can find the position of G point. So mark G here and join O and G and measure that length. That length will give the velocity of G point. Okay, so in this method we can do of finding velocity of any point which is on the connecting rod, some G point, some C point, like that. Whenever steam engine problem has given, if diagram is not given, do the diagram roughly like this, like triangle. Okay, for steam engine triangle will come. Okay, in the shape you have to do space diagram by taking the scale, and as well as you have to do the velocity diagram. These two diagrams you have to do neatly in the sheet. Okay, for getting the correct answers use the drafter properly. So in this method we can find the velocities.